Hello everyone and welcome to today's video. So today we're going to be going over the main blood vessels in the body. So going over the arteries and veins using the model that we have in a laboratory because this is the model that will be labeled for the practical. So this is the one you want to know. So starting out here, now I'm not going to label everything like I've done on the previous lab models here just because there's so much to label. So I'm just going to be talking out loud and discussing them as we go. And following the blood flow as we move through it. So we come out of the aortic valve right here. The first part we come through is the aortic arch, the first part is the ascending aorta, and then we go through the aortic arch here, then down through the descending aorta, becomes the thoracic aorta, that then comes down into this region here. But then we have these three branches. We talked about these in the heart video. The first branch right here is the brachiocephalic branch. Next branch will be the left common carotid artery, and then the right branch then is then the the right branch on the image, but the left branch overall would be the left subclavian artery. So first I want to go out the brachiocephalic trunk right here. Brachiocephalic trunk, one branches then into the right common carotid artery and then goes into the right subclavian artery. Then as we move down through, becomes the axillary artery in the armpit. And then when it gets down to the arm, it becomes the brachial artery in this region here. So I'm going to erase these little arrows and we're going to advance the video forward. And I'm going to move down the arm a little bit. So here we move down the arm. So here again is that brachial artery. And then after the elbow, it branches into two arteries. They're named based on the bone they run to. So right here we have the radius, so this is the radial artery, and then right here we have the ulna, or this is the ulnar artery. So radial artery and ulnar artery. One of these arms is flipped. All right, yep, so I got those wrong. It's the other arm. I go down the other arm, it's pronated and supinated. So one thing you want to note on this model, one is flipped. And I screwed up the arms saying which one's flipped. So remember, radius is always lateral. So over here, we have the radial artery, and here we have the ulnar artery. Because here's the thumb, anatomical position, radius is always the lateral bone. So don't make the mistake I just did. Then down here at the base of the hand, we have, moving back down just a little bit here, zooming in on the hand right here, we have this superficial palmar arch right here. So this little arch right here, superficial palmar arch, and then we go down through the digital arteries right here. So then erasing that, we can then move forward. I then show the other arm, not much different, it's just showing the flip position, and then over here we also have what's called the deep palmar arch. So there's a superficial and a deep palmar arch on this model. Now, coming back to center, we now move up through to the head. Remember, we have the left and the right common carotid arteries coming up. So right here we would have the left common carotid, and over here we have the right common carotid. Now, branching off of the subclavians, these are called vertebral arteries. And then if we just follow, so this one would go back onto the other side of this model and up through the other side of the head. So we're focused on the left side of the head here. The common carotid breaks into the external and internal common carotid. This one then breaks into the facial artery. So the external breaks into the facial artery and then comes up as the superficial temporal artery. And then that just goes out to the rest of the head. So we're not going to dive too far into all those branches there. Then as we continue moving through, we then can move down the model here. And again, we're just focused on arteries right now. We'll come back and do the veins later. Moving down, we have the descending aorta. So descending aorta coming out through the diaphragm here. So up there, it's called the thoracic aorta. Now it's called the abdominal aorta. So in this region right here, it's called the abdominal aorta. So don't forget that. The ones that go to the kidneys here, These are called the renal arteries. So there's a renal, a left and a right renal artery. And then there are the celiac trunk right here, going to the liver, the spleen, and so forth. And then there's all these other little branches, superior, inferior, mesenteric arteries. So down here is the inferior mesenteric going to the inferior portion of the intestines. And up here is the superior mesenteric artery going to the superior portions of the intestines. So we're moving down through this abdominal aorta and we hit these two branches. So what are these two branches? These branches are the iliac arteries or the common iliac artery. So coming down through here, so this would be the right common iliac and this would be the left common iliac. And then there's a little branch right here and that's where it becomes the external and the internal common iliac. So these ones would continue as the external and these ones are then the internal ones. And then this one right down here is the gonadal arteries. Then continuing, moving down through the legs, we then get to, watching the external iliac here, moving down through it becomes then the femoral artery. So the femoral artery, guess what, runs along the femur. So anything labeled in this region right here would be the femoral artery. Right here would then be external iliac, and then this right here is just common iliac. So right there is femoral artery all the way down through the knee region. And then as it gets to the knee, right here, this region is then called the popliteal artery, the one that runs behind the knee here. So I guess it would be showing this branch right over here as well. So the one that runs behind the knee. So just erasing that now, working our way back down to the, so that was the arteries of the thigh. Now the arteries of the leg, we have the anterior tibial artery and the posterior tibial artery that go down the leg. So right here we have, showing the tibia. This one shows the leg turned out. So this is the one that runs down through the calf. So this one is the posterior tibial artery. Here I'll draw on it. So posterior tibial artery, then this one is the anterior tibial artery. Then finally, moving down through to the foot, then we have the one that goes across the top of the foot. The only one that really matters here for us, this is called the arcuate artery, which is a cool one. Just like we have the one in our hand, we also have the one on our foot. Okay, those are the arteries. Oops. Now, we also have veins. So veins I'll go through pretty quickly just because a lot of them match the arteries. Now, there are more veins than arteries, remember. And the ones that are next to the arteries are usually named like those ones. Like, there are some different ones. So let's kind of start by draining the leg. So down here, we drain the leg. So we have the dorsal venous arch now in the foot. Coming up the leg, we have the posterior and anterior tibial veins. So same thing. Now this model doesn't show veins too great. I will warn you there, so I won't get too specific if I have to label veins. The one that runs behind the knee here is also called the popliteal vein. Now the important one in the leg is right here. So this one is one that's slightly different than the rest. This is called the great saphenous vein. So this is an important one to remember, and no artery is named like this one. It runs down the inner thigh right here. So if you ever see something on the inner thigh, it's the great saphenous vein. So an important one there. And then becomes the femoral veins. Those are the same, not on this one over here though. So femoral vein, and then the iliac veins as well. So common iliac, external iliac, internal iliac, and so forth. Then moving up through the abdominal region then, the inferior mesenteric vein, superior mesenteric vein, renal veins coming from the kidneys, hepatic portal veins coming from the liver. So again, kind of similar to the arteries in this region. Important ones here would be the big one that forms right up the middle. This is the inferior vena cava. It starts all the way down here. So if you I could label it down in this region here, and it's still the inferior vena cava. Here would be the renal, here would be hepatic, here would be splenic, and so forth. just a few examples of ones in there. And then moving back up through, don't forget about, I didn't mention the lungs for the arteries. So here, going out to the lungs with deoxygenated blood, all the pulmonary arteries, and then the red ones coming back in again, remember, all the pulmonary veins. That's this little pulmonary circuit right there, much smaller than the systemic circuit of the rest of the body. All right, almost forgot about that. Now let's drain the head. So now draining the head, we have a lot of sinuses up there that store a lot of blood. They're called dural venous sinuses, and then they drain down into the external and internal jugular veins. You have your vertebral veins, just like the vertebral arteries, and so forth. So the big one right here is the jugular. And we all know the jugular right here. The big one's the jugular. And then it has the internal jugular and the external jugular breaking off into the facial regions and so forth. So it's not called the common carotid vein. It's called the jugular vein. So important difference there for what drains the head, even though they run beside each other. And then going back again, we now can drain the arms. So again, we have, go down this arm here, which actually shows the veins. So we have a digital veins that are draining the hand. We come up along the radius and the ulna again. We have the radial veins and the ulnar veins. And one important one I wanted to highlight right here, this is called the median cubital vein. This is the site where blood is typically drawn and crosses over the inside of the arm right here. We all know that one pretty well. We all have gotten blood drawn before. So then backing up a little more, we're going up the arm. Now there are some branches in the arm. The inside here, we have the basilic vein. Here, let me move up just a little more before drawing to show the whole armpit. So here it gets a little confusing. Here's the basilic vein. And then on the outside of the arm, we have the brachial, or no, the cephalic vein. So right here would be the brachial vein. It kind of stops right there. And then this one on the outside is the cephalic vein. Cephalic vein just means it's going towards the head, but it doesn't go to the head. Remember, all these are veins, so they're going this way as well. So basilic vein, brachial vein, cephalic vein, they all then join together as the subclavian. Right here is then also considered brachial, where these two join, coming back up through. So there's brachial. Then right here, it's subclavian. Right then, here's the jugular coming back in. Then this becomes the superior vena cava. Right here is the subclavian returning from the left side of the body. And then it all comes back into the right atrium. So those are the veins and the arteries of the body. Here, I'll go through this video just a few more times right here, just highlighting the important things. We'll just play it through, and then we'll end when it's done. It's supposed to play. There we go. So just playing it through nice and slow right now, just so you get a good representation of this video. Again, if you have questions on this, please let me know. Again, this would be the model I would label for the practical, so it's important to know this model. I know this model isn't perfect, and I know that 3D organon thing is nicer, but I don't label the 3D organon program for the practical that we do in the classroom. So this is the one that will be labeled. So if you have questions on this and you're not sure which one is which, feel free to take a screenshot, send me a picture of it, and we can figure it out. So there again, showing the head, just showing through the whole video without pausing and me jumping it around. But yeah. Not horrible, but it's doable. Again, this model simplified, doesn't show everything. There are a lot more than this, a lot deeper veins and things like that, such as the azygous veins in the thoracic region. So this doesn't go through them all, but it does a decent representation of it. So with that, goes back up and then goes back to heart center, and then the video finishes. So we'll stop it there. And if you guys, again, have any questions, feel free to reach out. And I hope you all have a great day, and bye-bye.